I search for life's meaning, enslaved by the world and my greed. Then the door of my prison was opened by love, for the ransom was paid, I was free. I'm free from the fear of tomorrow.
Everybody, good afternoon. My responsibility this afternoon is purely to pray for you. But before I pray for you, I just want to mention two things that I think climax is what we've been talking about on the entry of conception. Now, nafikiri bottom line tumesema kwamba kile Mungu angetaka kufanya kwa ajili ya maisha yako lazima kwanza yafanyike ndani yako. Yale Mungu angetaka kufanya kuhusu wewe lazima kwanza yafanyike ndani yako. Kanuni ya Mungu ni kwamba lazima uchukue mimba ya kile kitu anataka kukufanyia. Usipoichukua mimba itakuwa vikumu kwa Mungu kukufanyia. Kwa sababu mimba inachochea kibali ama uwezo ama neema ya kulea mtoto. Mama kichukua mimba ndio masiwa inaanza kudevelop. Mama kichukua mimba mwili wake unaanza kuambatana na kanuni ya kufil mtoto. Kwa hivyo kanuni ya Mungu ni kwamba kabla Mungu achafanya kitu kwa maisha yako lazima uchukue mimba ya hiyo kitu. That's what I want to recommend to you. Going to church should be compulsory to you. Because you don't know what you can conceive that Sunday. Going for an evening fellowship or a midweek service in the church, going for all church programs is important. Because you don't know what you will conceive. Swala ni hii, kabla hujaichukua mimba ndani yako, Mungu hawezi kutengeza katika ulimwengu wako. God has to do it in your heart before it happens in your life. Naelewa kwa watu wa Mungu. Kile hukusikiza Kiswahili, kile haukuisikia hauwezi kuidai. Sawa? Adui anajua kwamba hawezi suia kile Mungu anataka kufanya kwako, lakini atasuia wewe kuichukua mimba. Once it's in the womb, it will show up in your world. Does that make sense? So you should make it a principle that you will be conceiving because you will bring forth. So that's why unakuta chumapili ndio siku ngumu kwa muka. Munaelewa kile nasema? Kwa sababu shetani anajua ni siku ya kuchukua mimba. Siku ambayo ungechukua mimba lunch wa shetani anatuma mtu wa kukununulia lunch na ni yule mchoyo normally. Wangapi ushatambua wakati unaamua kufunga na kuomba wachoyo wanakuwa wakarimu? That's right. Kwa sababu shetani anajua ni mimba unataka kuchukua. Listen. The devil knows the power of conception. Genesis ilisema mbegu ya huyu mwanamke itakanyaka kichwa chako. And from then henceforth, the devil has been fighting from the natural conception. But it's more real in the spirit. Mary aliconceive neno kabla hajapata mimba ya mtoto. Every time Mungu, nafikiri nishasema hapa either last year or last year part one, kabla Mungu hajafanya kitu chochote, huwa anainena, anaisema. Na wale tu wanaisikia ndio wanapokea. If you didn't hear it, you can't claim it. Kwa sababu imani uja kwa kusikia na kusikia kupitia neno la Mungu. I found that scripture say hearing by the word, not hearing the word. Hearing by the word. That means when you hear the word, you should the word should be the hearing aid to hear God. So the word should help you hear God. Now, what is the scheme of the enemy? Kumbuka kwamba neno la Mungu ni kama mbegu. Ngine iliangukia barabarani. That means the ability to conceive was not. Ngine ikaangukia mahali kuna mawe, ikachipuka kidogo lakini haikuwa na misisi. Ngine ikaangukia kwa miba, ikachipuka vizuri lakini suluhisho ama shughuli ya maisha ikaisababisha haikumea. Lakini ngine iliangukia kwa mchanga nzuri. Neno la Mungu ni mbegu, lazima ipate mchanga. Hello? That's why katika moyo wako lazima ungoe miba sote. Na nasema hizo miba ni issues ya maisha, kukwaswa, kusumbuliwa, kufutwa kazi, biashara, kesho, ugonjwa. Hizo ni miba. It has a way of choking the word. Make sure you undo it. Okay? Na Jumatatu tulisema, ama last week Friday tulisema kwamba, hakikisha kwamba you update your data. Your mind is too much congested with wrong information. Good to see you, man of God. It's too much fed with wrong information. There is too much negativity. So you need to format your mind. Eliminate what is not right. Create some space for some good news. Because the information that remains within you will influence you. Usiseme kwamba hatiyo habari hata kama sijafanya. As long as it is within you, it will affect you. You need to format your mind. Remove, delete. Make sure the space for more data is created. Delete negativity. And so we said yesterday, we stopped yesterday by talking about the power of association. And let me tell you something, friends, for free, from a point of advice. The association you keep, the company you keep, determines your conception. I guarantee you for sure, I know very promising people with wrong company. Your company paints your future. And then there are these people in life who are not sure exactly who they want to give company to. They are a friend to everybody. They can't put a finger and say, this is exactly my friend. And then there are these characters who never keep relationships. Kwa mwaka amekuwa na marafiki 100 na amepoteza wote. Kila mwaka na marafiki wapya. There are those people who never keep relationships. Kuna watu ukiuliza, wapi rafiki yako ya miaka 5 iliyopita? Hawana. Walipoteza kitambo. Na wenye wako na Isa hii wame mark yellow. Notice. Forget. I said in our pre-income service something which I don't want to repeat. But the emphasis is frustration is bad enough. But spiritual frustration is worse. When you are in a state where your spiritual life is in confusion, it's bad. It's bad. That's how people enter into a cult. But let's look at something today that I think will climax this. The reason why I stepped down for this celebration to go on is because conception, again, takes place in an environment of joy. Conception takes place in an environment of joy. Whenever you are filled with joy, it's very possible to pick what God is saying. The kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy. I think I've taught here and I've said the signature of God's approval in anything he does, one is peace, one is joy. You remember what I said? Anytime there is joy, it's easy to pick healing. It's easy to pick a word than when you are sorrowful. Now listen to this. I have been in two positions. When you're going through frustrations and there is no joy in your life, it's very possible to pick wrong signals. Let me say that again. Wakati unasumbuka na kuna kuchanganyikiwa kwa maisha yako, it's very possible to pick wrong signals. It's possible to pick wrong signals and make a conclusion. And what the problem with wrong signals is, when you pick a wrong signal, everybody else becomes wrong except you. And you get into a position where I don't care. I have my conviction. When you get to a level where you isolate yourself based on your new conviction, which were picked in an environment where you are alone with the Lord, and probably the environment was a state of frustration, discouragement, there is a probability you pick the wrong signal. And then every time you meet people, everybody is wrong except you. Joy is an environment of conception. But now this is the climax part of it. How do you find joy? David says, Nehemiah says the same, that the presence of God brings joy. His presence brings joy. And Nehemiah says, the joy of the Lord is our strength. I want to give you some thoughts that I think it's very important. I want you to know this. Nurture the pleasure of his presence. Nurture the hunger, the longing, the desire for his presence. Three things, and then I'll pray. Number one, learn to develop the consciousness of his presence. Uchifunse kujua namna ya kuhisi. Consciousness ni kuhisi, eh? Learn to develop the consciousness of the presence of God. And I think we need to talk about that for a moment. How do you nurture the presence of God? What one I say, manilisikia Mungu, I was in the presence of God. And God said to me, and sometimes you are like, anakujanga ama tunaendanga. Have you ever been there? And the Lord spoke to me and you wonder, wanakutananga wapi na watu? Ama ni nini unafanya ndio Mungu akuje? You know, you need to nurture that consciousness of the presence of God. And this is the simplest way I want to give it to you. When you get to an environment, or whenever you are thinking about the things of God, bring all your thoughts and your mind to think on God. That's how you trigger his presence. You can never trigger the presence of God when your thoughts are wandering. When you are singing, like when we are celebrating, let all your focus and attention be in that song. That's how you catch the presence, the spirit of that environment. But if you are singing and your mind is thinking about somebody else, and you are watching how somebody else is jumping, and you are thinking about somebody who hurt you. By the way, have you discovered every time ukifika church, ndio unaanza kufikiria ni nani alikukwaza, nani alibeba vitu yako? Have you ever been there? Lakini ukitembea kwa street haufikiriangi. Lakini ukifika tu church ndio kuabudu nafikiria, na nani alikuwa anamaanishaje siku ile? How many of us normally suffer that problem like me? And then all of a sudden, you're thinking. Learn to put all your concentration on what is happening. When you are praying, let all your thoughts and your focus be in prayer. That's how you trigger the presence of God. When you are singing a song, concentrate on the song. There are people who anaimba wimbo. That's why tunaimbanga wimbo vibaya, because we don't even think about the words we sing about. That's why sometimes unakuta mtu anaimba wimbo, asomi yenye iko pale, mawazo yake iko away. You've grammed the song. I've also discovered people can speak in tongues until they take the form of tongues, but they no longer portray the life of tongues. I know liars who speak in tongues. I know people who can speak in tongues until you feel God. And they make the next step and speak evil. Concentrate, focus. That's why in Israel, not necessarily in Israel, whenever they worship in God, they created it in a way that when you enter, there was a place where they called the outer court, where you deal with your personality. And then you enter the inner, and then there was the holy place, and then the holy of holies. As you go in, there is nothing that can distract your mind. Your thoughts are, I am going to meet God. Always learn to nurture the consciousness of the presence of God. And that tells you, you will be so conscious to an extent you cannot be chatting a stranger in the service. You have the sense of the fear of God. You cannot be hearing the word of God and you are telling your girlfriend, I am almost through. You cannot. And let me tell you something. If you think you are smart enough that you can still hear the word of God and you are chatting, I want you to know you are becoming stupid. Because even the reference of God doesn't exist in you.
How can you come to the house of God and chat somebody who is not in the house of God while you're in the house of God? You're even telling that person you don't value what you're doing. Hello? It's like you are talking to your wife and she's chatting somebody else. It's as ugly as that. Nambia, I love you, and Nambia, I love you. Ama mjui ya vitu natendeka. Learn to nurture the consciousness of the presence of God. Say that with me. Nurture the consciousness of the presence of God. Let me give you a tech. Come on. Let me give you a tech on how. Give me some strings. Let me give you a tech on this. Look at, for example, this song. I'm thinking about the goodness of God. One of the reasons why we are closing our eyes is not because we are very holy. It's because you are so indisciplined with your eyes. You have to close your eyes to think. That's why you never dream when you are awake. You have to be shut to see. But some of you are so indisciplined. Look, for example. In your presence. Now, I'm talking about the presence. Then you need to ask yourself in your mind, how does the presence of God, if literally I was meeting God, how do I behave? Can I be in the presence of God like this? Hasambuyu God. How do I behave? There is that, not because it's a sign of holiness, but it's a sign of consciousness that you are in the presence of. Kneeling down is not a sign of holiness, but it's an expression that you are conscious of who He is. Lifting your hands is not necessarily worship, but the fact that you are worshiping, there is that consciousness that I'm worshiping a higher authority. The presence of God brings conception. That's why when I scare water, I was in the presence of God and the Lord said. Most of the songwriters who wrote meaningful songs, wachana hii songs ya kuandika kwa darasa, people who wrote songs, they were in the presence of God. Look at the Bible. You realize any meaningful writing that was written were written in an environment of the presence of God. You conceive in His presence. I just want to be where you are. Now, you must think about the words. I want to be where you are. Now, you cannot be saying, I just want to be where you are. Na lunch hour inaendelea. I just want to be where you are. Na unaenda kutafuta chips. That's not where He is. Dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. Anybody can say those words. Let's try it again. I just want to be where you are. Dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Listen to those words. Surrounded by your glory, in your presence, I just want to be. When you come, when you're leaving your place of work, put it in your mind that I'm not going for lunch. I'm not going to see a friend. I'm not going to waste time. I was not going just somewhere. I'm going to meet the Lord. as much as he lives in you, but there's this environment that is dedicated for your moments of conversation. If you left your place of work with that consciousness, I'm going to his presence. As much as he dwells in you, but if you left knowing that I'm going to have a conversation with him, by the time you get here, you will not need a song. You can conceive every day. By the time the ministration of the word comes, you've conceived. I also discovered you can never receive a touch of healing unless you have conceived healing. So a preacher will only confirm what you have already conceived. So what is my advice? Every time, even in home church, even in ushirika wa mtaa, even in lunch hour, even in midweek service, come with that consciousness. I am going to the presence of God. And when you get there, always deal with his presence at a personal level. Forget about everybody else. Do what you think will trigger, create that consciousness of his presence. Like lifting your hands, closing your eyes, finding a corner for yourself. In your presence. In your presence. Lord, I want. In your presence. Come with the consciousness of his presence. I finish by saying this. You can never enjoy his word beyond the consciousness of distance. If there is a sense that you are too far from where he is, the word will never find room. How do you know that? When you think about it, you bring it close. Let me show you something. Stand up. Stand right where you are. Let me show you something. I can look at her and admire her. But when I come close to her, something changes naturally. You feel, even if you are blind, you feel you are getting closer to somebody. But it's even more real when you shake a hand. You feel you're touching something. And as you get more closer, you feel you are touching something. But listen, if I was dead or my mind was absent, ushakutana na mtu anakusalamia na mawazo yuko mbali. Alafu naambia ulinisalamia sema wewe tulikutana na wewe wapi? You know, ama ule mtu wako na tabia mbaya na kuambia habari yako na anaendelea na mwingine. You know, there is that sense of his presence. That's where people conceive. The presence of God. Worship is the easiest point of touching the presence of God. Just close your eyes, everybody. Hallelujah. Say it again. Hallelujah. Imagine the Lord is seated in front of you, hearing you saying, in that environment, you reduce the distance, courtesy of your thoughts. Close your eyes, say, hallelujah. Come on, make sure you open your mouth. Think about his goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's say it again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. easiest way of bringing, quickening, creating the awareness of His presence. Look at me for a minute. If you learn how to trigger His presence, if it inaitwa ulcers, depression, stress, kupoeka, it will never happen. But every time you think about your problems, your confusion, and what is not happening, you expel that environment. God is not so far, but He operates in a given environment. Do you realize just by that, you feel like there is something closer to you? You don't struggle. When you pray to a God that is close, you never get tired talking to Him. I want you to love the presence of God. And I'll give you simple ideas right from your phone. Remove those ringtones that make fun. Put a ringtone that even if you don't want to receive my call, you can worship. You know what I mean by that? Put music around you. Put music around you. Put music on your phone, the ones you love. Let your environment be filled with what triggers. That's when your ideas. Let me give you my secret. 3/4 of the revelations I get it in an environment of worship. When I read the Bible in an environment of worship, I look at the scriptures and they are jumping out of the paper. When I read when there is no worship, I'm reading dryness. Nangaliyo vitu na shanga. It doesn't make a lot of sense. Worship brings healing. One day niliambiwa niko na ugonjwa mbaya that was eating me up, my spine. Guess how I got healed? Worship. Worship eliminates the desire for sin. Worship takes away the thoughts of hopelessness. You'll be surprised when a mubiri, mukristo, muchungaji, nisa singina na kete na nafikiria, na kukufa siyo mbaya. They contemplate suicide. Somebody begin to think something that contradicts what they propagate. The principle is the presence of God makes a difference. People conceive in His presence. Lift your hands up above your head. In the name of Jesus, for the last 3 weeks or so, we've learned on the principle of conception. We've talked about the loins of our minds. We've talked about the importance of our environment, the importance of sight, the importance of words, the importance of company or association. And today we talk about joy and more so His presence. I pray in Jesus' name that the Spirit of God will quicken our hunger for His presence. Like the Bible says, get into the closet and conceive. It's a place of His presence. And what you conceive in the closet, He will perform it in public. I decree today that each one of us will have the hunger for God. We will conceive our dreams. We will conceive our future through the word of God, through the thoughts of God, that the Lord is going to quicken His desires in our hearts. Like the Bible says, delight yourself in the Lord and He will fulfill the desires of our hearts. I decree that every wrong seed, every negative word, every wrong environment, every information in your system that is not part of the will of God for your life, that came from wrong source, the spirit of abuse and rejection, the voice that says you will never make it, I nullify it in Jesus' name. I
And I decree the mind of Christ, the mind of possibilities, the mind of favor, the mind of breakthrough. You will have thoughts of success. Divine ideas will be conceived in your spirit. You will see from God's point of view. I decree in Jesus' name, the anointing of God will wrap around your mind and your heart, that any negative word will not stick. Any negative word will not hold. Any negative word will not find room. Let your mind, let the environment of your mind rebel every negative word. We condemn every negative word. We nullify every negative word. And we decree the womb of your spirit will conceive the seed of destiny. You will be great. The mind of God will spring forth. Your dreams will become a reality. As a man of God, I prophesy to you, I breathe the breath of God into your dreams. You will conceive and you will bring forth. And there will be joy around you. If there is any negative word that has been spoken concerning you, your destiny, by whoever, I take authority from this altar and I nullify it in Jesus' name. And I give you a new assignment. You are the beloved of God. You are a mighty man of valor. You are graced for success. Whatever you touch will prosper. Where you tread, you possess. Whatever you see, you receive. Whatever you desire belongs to you. In the name of Jesus, I nullify failure. I delete the memories of your past negative experience. I delete the memories of the miscarriages you've gone through. I delete the memories of the abuses you've gone through. I delete the memories of negative influence. And I decree from today, it's a new day. His mercies are new. His grace is new. A new day springing forth. Last night, the Lord gave me a wonderful revelation from the rain that rained, that we've had a dryness for 5 months. But when the Lord opened the floods of heaven, within one day there were floods everywhere. I decree in Jesus' name, no matter the dryness that has been, by this word that I declare today, may the rains flood you. May you be wet everywhere. May you be so wet. May the flood flow that people who saw you dry will never recognize what happened overnight. May that rain into your business. May it rain into your rivers. Rain into your dreams. And I decree, your climate has changed. No more dust. No more dryness. It's a rainy season. Things will spring forth. And that is your portion. Receive it in the name of Jesus. And I decree, fumbi, kiangasi, kukaukiwa, imeisha. Neema ya imfua itasalisha upya. If you believe it, I want you to receive it with joy. That be so. Amen. So wale walikuona na fumbi jana watashangaa kuona mafuriko leo. Wale walikuta na fumbi jana watakuta huko na matope ya baraka. May that be your portion in Jesus' name. Do you believe it? Do you receive it? Celebrate it. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. And listen, before we step out, I know our time is up, but listen, that what remains, no more dryness.
The only difference you will see is the change of climate for harvest, not the drought.
Kwa hivyo hata ile shamba ilikuwa imekauka unaweza panda sasa kuna maji ya kumeesha.
So like my village is, if you went to my village from September, October, it was dry. But in the next few months, you go to my village, it's green. May that be your portion. In Jesus' name.